Hey everybody, welcome to another Pro Acoustics Tech Talk. I'm Nathan, and today we're going to talk all about mixer amplifiers and amplifiers and also mixers. What's the difference? What do I need for my project? Let's go ahead and start off by defining what an amplifier is, a power amplifier, and then what a mixer is, and then we can kind of talk about the difference between the two and how it all works. So basically, an audio amplifier is an electronic amplifier that basically amplifies an input signal up to a high enough wattage to where it can drive speakers. This will take basically an audio signal, transform that into electrical wattage, basically have that wattage drive the speaker to make the paper cone move to generate sound waves. So basically an audio amp is required anytime we're going to power a passive speaker. There's different types of amplifiers, class A, class B, class C, class D, I think I've heard of class H. I'm not going to spend a whole lot of time about that. There's different ways that an amplifier works internally, but what you need to know is that ultimately all of them take that audio signal, ramp it way up to wattage, and then drive your speakers. There's different types of amplifiers. There's more of the pro audio type amplifiers. These are made from companies like Crown, QSC, lots of the major amplifier manufacturers. Those are normally done for pro sound or installed sound with low impedance speakers for live music reproduction, music, also sometimes done for touring audio or places where very powerful, lightweight amps are really needed. Sometimes you also have built-in DSP, built-in networking, and things like that that can come in handy for pro audio amplifiers. Then we also have commercial amplifiers, which are normally designed and built to run 24/7, a little bit more robust, also have more commercial grade power supplies to be left on all the time. Normally those are designed for what commercial integrators and technicians need. Permanently installed cable connections on the back, things like EuroBlock and Phoenix plugs, and the ability to network the amplifier to control it remotely if needed. From there, we also have an audio mixer. An audio mixer is where you plug in lots of individual input sources so that you can control and adjust the actual audio signal. Now, when I say mixer, lots of times people think of these big, massive mixers like you see in the back of auditoriums or in the back of concerts. But anything that is electronic that has the ability to adjust the audio signal of a source or multiple sources is technically an audio mixer. We have a lot of those available from companies like Alesis, Rolls, things like that, that can be used in a lot of applications. So those mixers may be more pro audio or they may be more commercial audio, but the idea is they all still in some way allow you to adjust the audio signal and also match it to the appropriate output to drive an amplifier. A mixer amplifier combines basically the characteristics of a mixer and then also an amp. Mixer amps can be pro audio, in the case of like Yamaha, Behringer, Mackie, PV, some manufacturers along those lines. And then there's also more commercial grade mixer amplifiers like our Pure Resonance Audio brand, JBL Commercial, Bose, Denon Marantz Pro, and a TOA mixer amp like I have here. Those mixer amps have not only amplifiers built in, but also the ability to control multiple input sources. You can set the volumes, you can also adjust bass and treble and things like that from your amplifier, from your mixer amplifier. What's important there is not only does it allow for multiple input sources, but it makes sure that whatever device you're connecting is driving the amplifier with the appropriate signal you need to make sure you get the wattage required. Some 70 volt mixer amplifiers also have things like built-in priority, priority ducking, and all are built, designed to last and to run 24/7 with a lot of certifications from UL and things like that that are required for permanent installations. With the mixer amp, you not only have your amplifier built in, all in one package, but you also have whatever adjustments might be needed on that mixer amplifier so that you can just connect your sources and away you go. So lots of times people do ask, can I just use an amplifier and just connect my one device? Sometimes you really do need that mixer amplifier because personal devices or other consumer grade electronics don't always have a signal strong enough to drive an amplifier by itself. So we need to go with a mixer amplifier to allow us to rev up that audio signal, manipulate it, turn up and down the volume however we need, and then drive the internal amplifier to power our speakers. If you have questions about what makes the most sense, whether it's a mixer amplifier, commercial mixer amplifier, a mixer, anything else you might need, be sure to reach out to us. My name's Nathan. Drop us a like down below. Let us know if you're watching and if we can help with anything else. Thanks, guys.